Hey everyone, I'm Carissa and I'm back with Ramiro to continue our Azure AD architecture series on App Proxy.
Hello everyone. In this video, we're going to see how Azure AD Application Proxy works with applications that use integrated Windows authentication. That is a very common scenario for typical intranet websites. We're building on top of our previous video where we explained what are the fundamentals of Azure AD Application Proxy. So make sure that you check it out. Let's say that we have a benefits intranet application that we built back in 2003 with ASP.NET in an on-premises data center in North America. And Susie over here is working from home trying to access that application. Since the app is integrated with Azure AD, Susie can go to My Apps portal and see it from there and click the benefits icon. With this setup, Susie's browser will first reach to the Azure AD App Proxy cloud servers here in step one. And when the request is received by the cloud service, it needs to determine the underlying application configuration based on the URL sent by the client. In step two, the App Proxy client service looks up in Azure AD the application that has the closest match based on the URL hostname and path. In this case, the application is configured to use pre-authentication, so the cloud service will redirect the user to the authentication service here in step three. The authentication flow takes place and the security controls will kick in as configured by conditional access policies. We take a step back. What we just did here is to put MFA, device-based conditions and/or controls, and all these modern identity-driven capabilities on top of an application that we built in 2003. I think it's very cool and very compelling. After step three is completed, Susie's browser will receive a token and it will be redirected to the external endpoint again. The App Proxy Cloud Service will validate the token and it is now ready to reach back to the on-prem app here in step four. At this point, we are transitioning to the on-prem world. So Carissa, you wanna take it over from here?
In step five, the App Proxy Cloud Service queues up the message for a connector on-premises to relay to the internal on-premises web server. Here, the connector that picks up the request needs to translate the Azure AD request to access the benefits website into a Windows integrated auth request on-premises. For that to happen, we need a few things. First, the connector knows who the user is from, given the request coming from the App Proxy Cloud Service. This comes from the claims from the user token from step three. Second, the connector needs to know the on-premises SPN of the benefits website. This comes from the App Proxy configuration. And finally, we need the on-premises machine account where the connector runs to have delegation permissions. This is why the App Proxy connector machines need to be domain joined. With all these pieces of data, the connector requests a Kerberos ticket for the benefit site using Windows APIs and Kerberos constrained delegations in step six. And with that, performs the HTTP request to the internet web server in step seven. Once the connector receives the HTTP response, it will send it back to the cloud service in step eight, which in turn sends it back to Susie in step nine. So I'll pass it back to Ramiro.
One thing to keep in mind here is that a single application might use multiple web servers. So you need to publish multiple endpoints in that case. And this is a very common scenario with applications such as portals where multiple apps are combining a single user page. So what are the key takeaways from this video? First, Azure AD App Proxy enables you to publish on-premises applications that use integrated Windows authentication and enable the Azure AD App capabilities such as MFA, My Apps Portal, signing reports, etc. All of that without changing any logic in the application itself. Applications on-premises should be configured to use Kerberos. That is how the connector translates the cloud authentication back to on-premises. Finally, make sure that all connectors are properly configured for delegation. This includes permissions to all the SPNs of the published applications, optimize the access to the domain controllers, etc.
All right, that's it for this video. I hope you found it useful. If you want to learn more about Azure AD Application Proxy or any other component of Azure Active Directory, make sure that you check the Azure AD Architecture series. We put a link on the box below so you can check it out. Thank you so much and see you next time.